Hello viewers, welcome to the video lecture of CLog function. This function is useful for allocating multiple blocks of memory. It is declared with two arguments. One first argument is for the number of blocks. Second argument stands for the size of the each block. Only difference between the malloc and CLog is that malloc allocates single block of memory, whereas CLog allocates multiple block of memory each of same size. The malloc allocate one large block of the given size. The CLog allocate the multiple blocks of memory, each memory contain the same size, and set all bytes to zero. The CLog initialize all the memory space to zero. Malloc will not initialize that. That is the difference between the malloc and the CLog memory allocation functions. Now we will see the syntax. PTR is a pointer variable, equal to data type star is the type conversion. CLog is the function name. Within the open and close parenthesis, we are having the two parameters. Okay, the first parameter is n, second parameter is byte size. The n stands for the number of block, byte size stands for the size in bytes for the each block. Okay, so multiple blocks of memory of the same size is allocated by using CLog function. Example, PTR is the pointer variable, integer star is the typecasting, CLog is a function. We are giving 4, 2. 4 stands for the number of blocks is 4, each block which contain the 2 bytes. The above declaration allocates the 4 blocks of memory and each block contain 2 bytes. The base address is stored in the integer pointer. So integer pointer is declared in the program and the base address is stored in the integer pointer. Like malloc, call log also allocate and send the void pointer. That is converted into integer by using the type conversion. Okay, so we can use whatever variable we want to store. For example, to store a float, we can give a float star and pointer should be a float pointer. Likewise, we can use it for the character also. Now, next the function is a free function. The free function, this function is used to release the memory allocated by the memory allocation function. So we are having a malloc and CLog function. The memory allocated by the malloc CLog function are realloc. Okay, these functions are released by using a free function. So within the free function, we have to pass the point variable which hold the memory address written by the malloc or CLog function. Okay, this free function also having the prototype in the header file stdlib.h. Now we have to write a C program. Okay, our problem is write a C program to allocate multiple blocks of memory using CLog function and release the same using the free function. After our program, after the our purpose is over, we have to release the function. So I am opening my code block and create a new file. I am saving the new file as CLog demo. Okay, CLog demo is my file name, and I have a file in this name. I am giving CLog demo 1. So now I am declaring, okay, include header files first. Okay, hash include stdio.h standard input output header file, and followed by hash include stdlib.h. okay, stdlib.h which contain the prototype of the all dynamic memory allocation functions like CLog, malloc and realloc and free also. Now we are going to I'm going to declare the main function void main. So within this main function, I am declaring an integer variable, okay, that is n, and I am initializing the variable j which is equal to 0, and I am initializing, okay, and I am creating a variable that is star p. okay, is a pointer variable. Now I ask the user printf, okay, slash n for the new line, enter the range of numbers. So I am asking how many numbers in total the user wants to enter. I am storing it in the variable scanf percentage d comma ampersand n. I am storing it in the variable n. Okay, now I have to allocate the memory p point, which is equal to integer star is a type conversion CLOC. Okay, so in the code block environment, which allocates 4 bytes for the integer variable, so the total number of variable is obtained as an input. How many numbers user want to enter is obtained as an input n. So I am giving n comma the size of integer means, okay, so for n is a size of integer, generally the code blocks will allocate 4 bytes. For one integer value, it will allocate 4 bytes, and one will create a one block with 4 bytes. If you give a 2 integer value, 2 blocks of 4 bytes will be created. If it is n is 5, 5 blocks of the size, each block which contain the size of the 4 will get created. Okay, so this is the function of the CLOC function. Now I am checking if the memory is allocated, if p equal to null, okay, then I am printing. Okay, null means the memory is insufficient and not allocated. Okay, if CLOC function return null if the requested memory is not available in the free memory space. I am writing a printf statement, printf slash n the memory is not available. Okay, then I am exit the program. For this, I have terminate the program. I am giving exit the parameter 0. Okay, if memory is available, if memory is not available, the CLOC will throw null value. If the point variable contain the value are null, then I will give a print statement, memory is not available, then exit 0. So otherwise, I ask the user, I am writing a while loop, while, okay, j's initial value is 0, okay, j which is not equal to n, okay, 0 which is not equal to, for I am assuming a value 5, which is not equal to 5, what I am doing, ask the user, printf, enter number percentage d comma j plus 1. What it will do, it will ask the user, enter number 1, number 2, number 3, vice versa. So scanf percentage d comma p plus j, okay, what it will do, it will first j value is 0, 0 is not equal to 5, and a print statement will be displayed to the user, enter number 1. So enter number is stored in the memory location, the p actually it points the first block. Okay, so p plus j equal to 0, it points the first block. Okay, entered values will be stored in the first block. Now I am increasing j. Okay, I am increasing j. So what will j is become 1, j not equal to n, it will come now and show enter the number 2. Enter number is stored in the next block. Okay, base address p plus 1 is the next block. Okay, then j, whenever j get increased, until the value will be get stored in the consecutive blocks. Once j reaches n, it will come out of the loop. Okay, we will run and check, okay, whether it is working correctly. Okay, I save the program, I am run the program. Okay, there is some error is shown. So what is the error? It shown my error is, okay, error the, okay, oh, okay, I am giving, I have to give 0. So this is an error. So we should not confuse between the 0 and O. So enter the range of number, I am giving 3. So now it will ask, enter the number 1, I am giving 1, it will get stored. It will ask, enter the number 2, I am giving the 5. Enter the number 3, it will giving a 4. Okay, so further statement, I yet to write the further statement. So my input is working perfectly. Next, I have to print the value which is stored in the consecutive blocks. I am again initializing j equal to 0. Okay, I am writing this loop while, okay, while j not equal to n. This time I am writing a print statement, okay, within the while loop I am writing a print statement, printf, okay, slash n number, okay, percentage d is percentage D. I am giving a value. Okay, J plus 1, comma. Okay, what I am doing? Star of, okay, star of P plus J. Okay, what it will do? Initial level J equal to 0, it will store the number. Okay, J plus 1 is base address plus 0. It represents the first block. Okay, the value in the first block will be retrieved and printed. Okay, I am incrementing J. Okay, what it will do? Again, J will take the value 1. Okay, 1 is not equal to N, it will come inside. Okay, number. Okay, I will bit close. Number 2 is percentage J plus 1 is 2, percentage D is, okay, the first block plus 1, it represents the next block. Whenever J get increased, the each block will get printed, okay. J will go from 0 to N minus 1, okay, it will print all the value. When it reaches N, it will come out of the block, okay. Now we will run the program and check the output. Okay, I am giving 5, number 1 is 10, number 2 is 20, number 3 is 30, number 4 is 40, number 5 is 50. So again, this is my output, is working perfectly. Number 1 is 10, number 2 is 20, number 3 is 30, number 4 is 40, and number 5 is 50. Yeah, so our logic is working very perfectly. Okay, to add some to clear clarity of the output, we'll give a print statement. Okay, slash n. Okay, enter numbers are, okay, it will give a title. Okay, numbers are colon slash n. Okay, now it will add some formatted output as. Okay, again I'm running the program. My program asked me enter the range of the number. I'm giving 5. First number is 100, second number 200, third number 450, fourth number 600, fifth number 1000. Okay, so my output is, okay, enter the numbers are, okay, my output. Number 1 is 100, number 2 is 200, number 3 is 450, 4 is 600, 5 is 1000. Okay, our programming logic is working perfectly. Okay, by using pointer without using array, you are storing the values in the each block, and as well as we are retrieving the values. So to number of blocks, we get it as an output from the user. It is an integer value we are going to store. That's why the size of each block is decided by using size of integer. Okay, that is the best way to give. We should not give explicitly the value for the each block. Sometime the allocation value of the each data type will vary from compiler to compiler. That's it for this video lecture. Thanks for watching it. Those who yet to subscribe my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel. Okay, that's it for this video lecture. Thank you.